Hello, everybody. Francis here. So today we are going to be talking about how you can crack passwords as a pen tester or ethical hacker, but also how attackers crack passwords of users, right? But also passwords of documents. So, for instance, you can use this if you forget the password of a document that you've added a password to. You can use it to crack it. Tools that we are going to be using include John the Ripper, which comes with Kali, and Office2John, which you can easily install. Okay, so those are the two tools that we are going to be using. So just a quick background. Hopefully you know that when you go to a site and you want to sign up, for instance, it doesn't matter what that site is. If they are doing any security practice at all, when you enter your email here and your password, okay? And then you hit sign up. The thing that they are going to save as your password is not the thing that you've entered, right? Instead, what's going to happen is they're going to change whatever you've entered. So in this case, all right, this is the password you've entered, okay? And then they will hash that password that you've entered. And it will generate a hash value. All right. So this hash value is what they are going to save in their database. Okay. So, for example, the database would look something like this. All right. So this is then the hash value of every single password that different people have now entered at the sign up stage, for example. Right. So during the sign up process. Okay. So this is how the database is going to be looking. Why is this important? When an attacker breaks into the database, or if an attacker breaks into the database and is able to view the file, they will be able to view the hash value and not the actual password, right? So, which is useful, for instance, if somebody is using the same password across different platforms, if somebody has a pattern of formulating their password, it gives that extra protection, right? Why does it work? Because when you hash a value, if you hash a value, like we saw earlier on, you cannot reverse it, right? So you can only hash one way, like so. So in this case, you hash a text, whatever the password is, it gives you a hash value, right? If you have this hash value, you cannot derive the original text back from this hash value, right? So that is ideally. That means that if those attackers were then able to access this database, they will not be able to get the original passwords from this hash value, at least in theory. Okay, so that's how it works. And these are some of the techniques that some organizations apply to protect themselves, right? So when you attempt to log in next time, okay, so they will take your passwords at the login stage and then compare, obviously hash it again, right? When they hash it, they get a value of the password that you've just entered now that you're requesting to log in. So they will compare that with that hashed value which they have stored in their database. If the two match, if the two are the same, then yes, you'll be logged in. It works again because anytime you hash the same thing, you will get the same hash value. So if your password, for example, was John, right? It will generate a specific hash value for John. Anytime you enter John as your password, trying to log in, it will be hashed again and the value will be the same. Therefore, you will always be able to log in. Okay? But there is a problem because attackers, when they get to this kind of database, they try to break it. Okay? They try to crack these passwords using things like rainbow table attack. So they will use different tools to try to do this. I want now to show you one of the tools and how they do it. The tool we are going to use is called John the Ripper. All right? We are further going to apply this to try to crack the password of any document. For example, if you forget the password of a document that you've added password to, you can use this to crack it. So let's get it started. So the first thing I'm going to do is to hash a few passwords. So, and these passwords will serve as the ones that are in those database that we're going to then crack. So for instance, I could enter simple passwords, okay, to start with. And then it will generate these hashes. All right. I'm gonna copy the hash, all right, and paste it in a text file. Okay. So now I've now pasted it, and I've also added two more text files. Okay. So I'm going to then save this, okay, as you know, save it as a file, and it will be representing the file that an attacker would find when they break into a database and then see the table that contains the hashes. Let's give it a go. So now I have the file saved. Quite simple. What I'm going to do next is basically call John. So I will use John, okay, to specify the tool that I want to use. And then I will just use this to make the display a little better or specify the format of the hash, you know, function that's been used. If I don't know this, there are so many different ways that I can find it, or I can even skip it, and John the Ripper will try to figure it out. Then this is the file that contains the hash, okay, which I want to decrypt. Let's give it a go. So that quickly, you've seen all the passwords now, you know, cracked. So the first one is QWERTY, the other one is dodgy, and the other one is password, right? So with this now, you will recover the original password from the hash, and that happens with the help of John the Ripper. Okay, so the second one that we want to demonstrate is how you can use this to recover the passwords of any document that you may have forgotten. Or if you're doing pen testing and you want to test the strength of passwords that are being used in that organization, how you can do it. So let's give it a shot. So to demonstrate that, I'm going to create a file, a Microsoft Word file like this. I've just entered this you know, content in the file, and I just want to then save it. Okay. So before saving it, I'll go to Info, and I'll go to Protect document, and I will go to encrypt with password, right? And then I will enter any password of my choice. So the password is added, and the file that I've just created, if I want to open it up now, it's going to be requesting the password. Okay, so let's say now that I've forgotten this password, and yeah, I want to crack it. All right, so the thing I'm going to do is then move this file to Kali and then use Office2John and then John the Ripper to crack it. Let's see how it works. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is to download it. I've removed the previous one, previous one that I have, just to ensure there is no conflict. So I will re-download it. Okay. So the link to download it using this wget, I'm going to paste this link in the description. So you can also download it if you want. All right. So now that I've downloaded it, the next thing is to make it executable. So I can use this command, chmod, and then the name of the file. As you can see here, the name of the file is Office2John that we've downloaded from GitHub. Okay, so make it executable, and that is done, right? So the next thing now is to run it. It's a Python based application. So I'm just going to run it on the file that we have created, right? So now, before we run it, anyways, so we've now set it up and ready to run. But yeah, before we run it, it's important to know that, you know, this is a step before you use John the Ripper. Like we saw earlier on, we use John the Ripper to crack passwords, you know, to crack the hashed passwords. The first thing we are going to do is to use this Office2John to try to then hash the password of that document to hash that document that we want to crack its password. Okay, let's do it. Okay, like I explained earlier on, here is what I'm doing. I'm running this Office2John, okay, and I'm running it on the file, the passworded file that we created on doc. All right, and we want to make a hash of this file and then put the hash in this file. So obviously, this is me just naming this a random thing. You can name it anything you like. So this thing here is obviously saying put the output of this first one to into this file, right? Let's see how it goes. Okay, so that has been done. We can cut that password, for instance. Apparently, there's been a typo there, and we have to maintain the typo. So let's say we want to see the content of this file, so we can use this cut to see it. You can see like it's a hash value, all right? So now I'm going to pass this value to John the Ripper, okay? I'm just gonna let it use its default, word list, just the simplest kind of command, to get this done. So nothing fancy, John, which is the command, and then this one. So if I want, I could add sudo, all right? Just to make sure there is no permission issues. And now we are ready to run it. Just like that, real quick, you can see the password here. It's now cracked the password. And when we go back to the document and enter this password, it will open, all right? So this is the file. I tried to open it and it says enter password. Then I enter the password that we just cracked and boom, it's now open. And this is the content of, the file. So this is how you can quickly use John the Ripper, but also Office2John to crack passwords of documents, but also passwords of, hashed passwords, right? As part of your pen testing or ethical hacking exercise, all right? Obviously, you can also use it if you forget the password to your own document. Office2John and John the Ripper can be a helpful way to crack it, right? So we've seen that that's a weakness. We are not supposed to be able to crack the passwords, whether it be the one that an organization have stored in their database or the one that's been used to password a document. So why is it possible for us to crack it? Well, it comes down to the type of password, okay? Whether the password has been used in multiple locations, okay? And also perhaps whether the password has been involved in some data breach. All of those make it likely to be included in some kind of word list, which some of these tools use for brute forcing. All right. So to further strengthen passwords when we save them, in the databases, we also use, sorting. Okay. So if we get back to this, instead of just getting the password, all right, and then hashing it, instead of just hashing the password, the thing we can do is to also add what is called salt. So essentially what salt is, when the person enters their password, for instance here, we will add something else. So without salt, it will be like this, okay? You enter the password and this will be the hash, and the hash is what is saved, right? With salt, you enter the password. We add some pseudo random stuff, or random stuff, and then use it to generate. So now it becomes this thing plus this one, and then we hash that too. So we get a different hash value. What does it add? If somebody is using this password in multiple locations and they've now been breached, right? The password will not be the same for those different locations because the salt, which is this one, can be different, right, for all of those. So this kind of adds a little bit more protection and makes it harder to be cracked. Okay. So hopefully this is helpful. Consider subscribing. Cheers.